Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंदगंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्
सदा शिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा
अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा आई वेलकम यू ऑल विथ माय लव एंड रेस्पेक्ट्स. Now let me enter into today's subject, Bhagavad Gita. I'll start from 21st verse. Atavyavastitan drushtva dartharashtran kapitvacha pravritte shastra sambatte धनुरुद्यम्य पांडवः ऋषिकेशं तथा वाक्यं इतं माघमहीपते. seeing the sons of Dhritarashtra arrayed in the battlefield, Arjuna, the son of Pandu, who was seated in his chariot bearing the flag marked with Hanuman, took up his bow and spoke these words unto Lord Krishna, the master of senses. First time Krishna's name is appearing in this great book, Bhagavad Gita. How to introduce Krishna? As I said, throughout this book, wherever his new names are appearing, I'll introduce that dimension of Krishna to all of you. It is impossible to introduce Krishna in one satsang. No. Please understand, like money attracts money, power attracts power, people attract more people, glory attracts more glory. Krishna is an embodiment of glory by his own right. So even if I remove all the glories attributed to him, all the miracles attributed to him, all the auspicious things attributed to him, and just express what he is, even for that, I don't think it is possible in one shot. So continuously, wherever he is introduced, I'll go on introducing him. Here, with the word Rishikesham, he is introduced. Arjuna says in the next verse, Arjuna uvacha सेनयोरुपयोर्मध्ये रथं स्थापयमेच्युत यावात् एतान् निरीक्षेहं योत्कामानवस्थितान् कैर्मया सह योत्तव्यम् अस्मिन् रणसमुद्यमे. ओ इन्फालिबल वन, प्लीज प्लेस माई चैरियट बिटवीन the two armies, while I may observe these warriors arrayed for battle and with whom I have to engage in fight. Senayor upayor madhye ratam sthapayamechyuta. He is addressing, O infallible one. A real leader. Arjuna is a real leader. He is not disrespecting. He is not poking. He is not saying, "Oh Krishna, let me see your army who has come to fight with you, who has come to stand against you." He is just simply asking, "Take me, let me see all the warriors with whom I need to fight. Let me see all the people I need to fight." In these two sutras, two names for Krishna, Rishikesham, Achyutam. I can say each name of Krishna expresses one dimension of Krishna. Oh, the infallible one. That's what exactly the name Achyuta means. See, Krishna is an incarnation. He is not evolved human being, descended spiritual being. Understand the difference. It is not in quantity, very quality difference. story for you guys.
Discover the secrets of health and wealth in one package. For the first time, a two-day health and wealth workshop by Paramahamsa Nityananda. Healing for a range of ailments. Wipe out illness from body, mind and being. Awaken your body's natural intelligence and healing powers. Overcome stress and powerfully resolve your wealth-related conflicts. Discover the secrets of creating and celebrating wealth.
Let me tell you step by step how you build the patterns. First, the memory. Morning 7 o'clock, coffee is very nice. After 1 month, it becomes samskara, engram. Morning 7 o'clock, I should have coffee. After 1 year, it becomes muscle memory. Means morning 7 o'clock, if I don't get coffee, I will feel little low mood. I'll feel low, feel little irritated.
Dynamic interactive awareness sessions that reveal the secrets of a perfect health and having abundance in wealth.
I will have headache. That is bio memory. After 6-7 years or 10 years, really one day you are caught somewhere, you are not able to get coffee and having headache, rolling on the ground, that is DNA level. Now understand how the memory becomes samskara, engram, engram becomes pattern, pattern becomes muscle memory, muscle memory becomes bio memory, bio memory becomes DNA level pattern.
Intense meditations and kriyas that holistically instill a transformed health and wealth consciousness in you. At Baroda, from March 24th to March 25th, 2012. Contact 91-851-11-25239.
Small boy, wondering how human beings happened on planet Earth, goes to mother and asks, "Mother, how did we all happen?" She says, "The beginning there was God, and God made the Adam and Eve, and from there the whole human race happened. We are all here." Anyhow, he wants second opinion. The child goes to father and asks, "Father, how did we all happen?" That guy says, "No, from the monkey we all evolved. Initially there were monkeys, and then after a long time we evolved, and here we are." Child runs back to mother and asks, "Mom, you say we came from Adam and Eve, God created Adam and Eve, and we came from that. Father says we evolved from monkeys. Which one is true?" Mother answers, "Well, dear, it's very simple. I told you about the origin of my side of the family. Your father told you about his side." Understand? You can always give the seat of origin either to God or to monkey. Anyhow, incarnations are not the human beings had breakthrough, their divine beings had breakdown. That's the right word. Divine beings who had breakdown. It is not ascendance, evolution. It is descendance. So incarnations are completely different beings. The very happening is in different level. The very base material is different. Please understand. It is not the way they are created is different. It's not the way they are made is different. The very base material is different. That is why Arjuna says, "O the infallible one." If you see factually, the word is not right. You can't say Krishna was infallible because he ran away from a war. So if you see with your eyes and ordinary facts, you can't say he is infallible. But he is infallible. He did not run away. He waited for the right time to attack back. Sometime not attacking is the right strategy, right plan. There is a beautiful verse by a saint called Thiruvalluvar in Tamil, who says the daytime crows can see. They will go and attack the birds, the owl, all these birds, which can see only in the night time. So the owls won't attack them back immediately. They will keep quiet. Once the sun sets, it becomes night. Crows can't see. Then the owls will come out and finish these fellows. So owls know when to attack. So it is an intelligence. Sometime your logic, which counts the facts, may not be able to grasp. But you need to wait a little bit to see the whole picture. Before seeing the whole picture, if you come to the conclusion, it is not only useless, sometimes dangerous. One more story for you guys.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself
and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
Couple lived together for 50 years in rural areas of a country, never went to a city, but decided to celebrate their 50 years of togetherness. So they went to a city and checked in a plush hotel. Few minutes, suddenly she started shouting at the bellman, "What is this? I cannot put up with this room. Just because we are new to the city, you guys are trying to cheat us. There is no window. There is no AC. There is no bed. There is no attached bathroom. What kind of room it is?" She started screaming. The bellman replied, "Madam, madam, please wait. This is not your room. This is the elevator. So please wait. You are only in elevator." So before seeing the complete picture, any decision you take, any conclusion you arrive, you miss and mess. Arjuna says, "I need to see the people with whom I have to engage in fight. Rana samudyame kairmaya sahayodhavyam asmin rana samudyame." In the next verse, Vyasa describes some more details. Yotsyamanan avekshehaṁ yayete atra samahataha dhartarashtrasya durbuddher yuddhe priyachikirshavaha. Let me see these well-wishers in this war of the evil-minded Duryodhana who have come together here to fight. Arjuna is expressing now his anger. But see, his anger is only restricted towards Duryodhana. He is not calling all the opponents as his enemies. He is not saying, "Let me see all my enemies." No. He is saying, "Let me see all the well wishes of Duryodhana. Many of them have come because Duryodhana supported them during these 14 years. See, 14 years is a long time to create new relationships. In these 14 years, when the Pandavas were missing in action, naturally, Duryodhana had the advantage of the power, position, power of a king, wealth, infrastructure, to create friends with all the small kingdoms. Even for 5 years, if you are not in the power, the other fellow swallows you. Of course, when these guys come back to the power, they dismantle the other guy. Here, 14 years, these guys were in forest, did not have any infrastructure, except the good name they earned from their past, good actions. But Kauravas had all the infrastructure, power. So naturally, they created a lot of good friends. Many of them are there in the field, in Gaurava's side just to honor their commitment to Gaurava, just to respect their friendship with Duryodhana, just because they can't say no to Duryodhana. See, now you need to understand the psyche of the people who joined the war. I'll give you some of the juicy details. There are only two people did not join the war. One, Balarama. Balarama decided, I cannot fight for any one of these fellows because both are equal to me. Bhima and Duryodhana, both of them are direct disciples of Balarama. In the art of fighting with mace, Gatayuta, the fighting with the mace is an art both of them learnt. Bhima and Duryodhana, both of them learnt directly from Balarama. So Balarama says, no, I can't fight for anyone. So I'll go for Tirthayatra. He leaves for Tirthayatra. And the second his original name is not recorded. His nickname only is recorded. He's called Anna Chola Raja. A Chola king from Tanjore, from the southern part of India, he went to the battlefield but decided he will not fight the battle, instead cook and feed all the warriors who are alive. So he took the responsibility of giving food for both sides.
Discover the power of Kundalini Awakening at Kalpataru, a unique full-day transformational program blessed personally by Rare Living Incarnation Paramahamsa Nityananda. What is Kundalini? Kundalini is the tremendous potential energy hidden inside every individual, which can be awakened through initiation by an enlightened master. Once awakened, Kundalini has the power to transform every area of your life and bring you health, wealth, success, joyful relationships and spiritual enlightenment. Harness the power of meditation and initiation. Experience a glimpse of Kundalini awakening at Kalpataru. Manifest your destiny. Every weekend at Nityananda Dhyanapetam, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru.
Yudhishthira side and Duryodhana side. And very beautiful description. This king everyday morning will go with food to Krishna. First day he kept 18 sweets. If Krishna takes two sweets and eats, the king knows now today 2 crore people will be dead. So that night he will cook for 16 crore people. Next day he will go with 16 sweets to Krishna. If he swallows 5 sweets, now king knows today 5 crore people out. So night he will cook only for 11 crore people. So exactly this way, he did not miss feeding even one person a day, did not waste food, even one extra person's food. Neither said no for even one person, nor wasted even one person's food. Only these two did not join the fight. I can say, Mahabharata war is the first world war. whoever was on planet Earth at that time. Please understand, the whole civilization was there only in this Indus Valley. The human beings have spread outside Indus Valley long after that. There are only one or two references. Some remote countries people were there, but even they also came and joined the war. It was practically the First World War, where the whole world was involved. So naturally, when that kind of a mood is created, see, war is kind of a romance. That is why always this war and romance is very closely connected. War is kind of a romance where you don't know what is going to happen next. And the thrill till the other person is dying is too much. And moreover, it is a kind of an expression of a collective violence. Millions of people are bored with life and they don't have the courage to commit suicide all alone. But when the whole group is committing suicide, they feel they are going to go wherever they are going together. They don't understand the moment you are dead, you are alone. Even if you commit suicide with 1 million people, the moment you are dead, you are all alone. We don't understand that. This is what is called mob psychology. When the mob is doing something, just flowing with it, losing your individual identity into the mob is a dangerous thing. But unfortunately, man is so unconscious. Always all the mob things are successful. Why do you think it takes so much of time and energy to spread spiritual truths? Because it is not based on mob, it is based on individual's experience. Here every individual has to feel connected, start transforming, experience levitation, and ultimately enlightenment. It is individual